Hello, I am Prakhar and I will be presenting saliency prediction for mobile user interfaces. This work was done at Adobe Research in India. So mobile interface includes UI elements such as buttons, links, text box, some are shown on the right image. Saliency prediction for natural images is a well-studied topic and vision. But given the difference in what constitutes a mobile interface as well as the usage context of mobile UIs, we postulate that saliency prediction for mobile UI images requires a fresh approach. So UI designers normally work with UI elements for actions like adding, removing, editing, etc. So we want to provide visual feedback to these designers for making better designs. So we want to address the problem of generating iGaze-based saliency prediction for mobile user interfaces. So the the saliency prediction should be based on both natural image kind of features as well as UI specific features. We want to predict element level saliency instead of pixel level saliency as shown in the right image. Now, there was no existing data set for such kind of work. There was no data set as well as the ground truth, I guess. So we created this data set ourselves by downloading 156 apps, Android apps from Google Play Store and taking 293 screenshots of those apps, ensuring good distribution over the downloads and ratings. We needed element level bounding box for these elements, so we had two methods for that. One was a semi-automated drag and crop method. The other was while capturing the UI images on the mobile itself, we used Android debugger tools and captured the bounding boxes using the XML code. So this histogram shows us the distribution of the UI elements per the elements per UI, and the average was around 20. Now we had to get the ground truth for these UI images. We did this experiment on Mechanical Turk, where 111 participants were shown on an average of 50 UI images, we showed these every image for 5 seconds and filled them with gaps and filler images. Then we built a iGaze pinpointing system where we extended the work of iTracker, which was a CVPR paper in 2016, to get pixel to get the exact location of where the user was looking at from the video we captured while he was looking at the image. Now we get the pixel level gaze points from this, and then we transform this to element level ground truth by doing the integral over the saliency density for all the pixels covered by an element. Now we have the data. So regarding our approach, our feature engineering approach consisted of using a stack denoising autoencoder, where this autoencoder tries to reconstruct the image of an element or image from its corrupted version. So we use the output from the output from the encoder. Now saliency is driven by visual contrast, and to capture this phenomena, we use the features from increasingly larger scales of the UI elements. The largest scale is the whole UI itself. We also use some low-level features like the color distribution, size, position, etc. of the image, UI element. Now, given these features, the saliency prediction model itself consisted of using these features along with the low-level features for the elements and their increasingly larger scales, and feeding it to a neural network, which its aim is to predict saliency for one individual element. And it uses, in doing so, because of this feature engineering, it learns the feature element-specific features as well as the contrastive features among the various elements themselves in doing the saliency prediction for the element. Now we get the predictions for every element and then normalize it for the whole UI. So this was our method. So we compared this method with a lot of other recent as well as known pixel level saliency prediction methods. For the other pixel level methods, we used a pre-trained model and got a pixel level saliency. And then again, using the previous procedure, we converted it to element level saliency. And then on this bunch of metrics, this we have shown that directly optimizing a system to predict saliency for at element level leads to better performance. Here are some qualitative results. Thank you and hope to see you at the